House cleaning. Raiders fire their coach, fire the offensive coordinator, fire their general manager. Hell, they ought to fire the owner, but that's not going to happen. A year and a half of failure is over. Josh McDaniels has been booted out. Boy, is his career plunged again for the second time. The offensive coordinator, Mick Lombardi, was ousted. The general manager, Dave Ziegler, had been there for a year and a half. He's gone. They leave behind a mess. A year and a half of failure. As they play this weekend, they're 30th in offense, 30th in scoring, and 31st in defense. And they have given up on Jimmy Garoppolo. Jimmy G has been demoted to third string. You look at the modern history, failed draft, failed in free agency, failed to develop young players, unrest at quarterback, paying a mountain of money to Jimmy G, to Josh Jacobs, to Devontae Adams, and they got a pedestrian offense. Some hideous losses this season. McDaniel, 9-16 with the Raiders after going 11-17 with the Broncos, 20-33. He's done. The most staggering thing is this is another coach off the Bill Belichick tree that has failed miserably. And he had two kicks at the can, so he's done. It'll be interesting to see where they go. I'll throw a name off the top of my head because he's had a bad week too. Jim Harbaugh, University of Michigan. Mm-hmm. If he's removed, it might well be that Mark Davis makes a run at him, and Harbaugh, who had success back with the 49ers and at Stanford, maybe he jumps back in to the National Football League. But that's where we are. I wasn't shocked, and their play just got worse and worse and worse. They had a 20-0 lead in the game to Arizona, and they lost it. They got creamed by a Division II quarterback in the Chicago Bears. Last week, they got mugged by a Lions team, and they were just incompetent. Garoppolo has been hurt again, despite his one-loss record. His statistics are terrible this year with the Raiders. The running back, Josh Jacobs, big money contract, over $13 million. He held out, hadn't done anything. Paying all this money, Devontae Adams, and that head coach targets him one time in a game. You got to be kidding me. So that guy was in over his head as a head coach. That was a bad hire. It's like all the other things Mark Davis has done, not very good. Your response to when a story broke at midnight early this week?
Like, it's about time, you know? I mean, I was surprised but happy that they got rid of the GM too, because they clearly don't have a good strategy here. I mean, Devontae Adams, great player. Josh Jacobs used to be a good player. Jimmy G is the guy that, you know, a good game manager. He's not going to win the game with his athleticism. But, you know, when he was at the Niners, he was complimented by so many great skill guys. He could kind of quarterback that point guard, that thing down the court. But Devontae Adams was just incensed how angry he was with how he was being used and how frustrating it was because Garoppolo was so, you know, off target with his throws. So, you know, at least when the Raiders had, like, back in the day, you knew that they were going with the vertical game. They had these monster guys and sometimes a little bit of bad character in there.
Oh, you think?
Yeah, you think. And so they had sort of a persona, a culture, a brand. Now, what does Raider football stand for? It's just a mishmash.
Here's a sidebar story that just kind of leaked out today as we were coming on the air with our podcast. Mark Davis held private meetings with Garoppolo, Josh Jacobs, Devontae Adams, and Max Crosby.
Oh.
And they all spoke out against McDaniel. Now, I don't know, in all honesty, if ownership going to individual star players, if that's a good move in terms of credibility. But he did, and when he heard all this stuff from those guys within that locker room, he hit the eject button. Okay, now that being said,